Hi everyone, in this video we're going to solve this recurrence relation. So to do it, we're going to start by finding what's called the characteristic equation, and then we'll go from there. So solution. So the equation is a sub n equals 2 times a sub n minus 1 minus a sub n minus 2, and we have these two conditions here. These are called initial conditions, and this is called a recurrence relation. If you're wondering where this comes from, oftentimes, not always, oftentimes these arise via counting problems. So you can model a counting problem via this equation called a recurrence relation. Then when you solve the recurrence relation, you're actually solving the counting problem. So it's kind of cool. Okay, so the first step in this method that we're going to use is to find what's called the characteristic equation. So the way I do it is, whenever I see an a sub n, I know that it's going to be x squared. I just memorize it. This is equal to 2, and then when it's n minus 1, it's x, and then this is a constant, so it's minus 1. If you've taken differential equations before, you might say, oh, this is really, really familiar. It is, except oftentimes in that class you use R or M, and it's called the characteristic equations. The same technique, so it's kind of cool if you know some differential equations, then what you're about to see here might seem familiar. So you always just, if there's an a sub n, you put a 2, n minus 1, you put a 1, this is always a constant. This is a quadratic equation, so we set it equal to 0, so minus 2x and plus 1. So we have x squared minus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. This factors, right? This is x minus 1 times x minus 1. I'm going to write it this way, x minus 1 squared equal to 0. And I'm doing that to emphasize the multiplicity of the 0. So x equals 1, that's our 0, or our root, or our solution to our equation. And the multiplicity is 2. So the multiplicity is 2. It's called the algebraic multiplicity. So now we can write the answer down, right? There's a formula. The formula says that whenever you have a repeated root, the solution to this equation would be a sub n equals, and I'll use a constant, big C1 for my constant. You can use any letter you like for a constant. Some books use alpha, some books use B. I don't want to use A because I've already used it. So big C1 times, and then it's going to be our root to a power. So this is our root. So 1 to the n plus. And because it's repeated twice, what you do is you repeat it again and you put an n times 1 to the n. So whenever it's repeated, you write it twice and you put an n. Say you had gotten 2 and 3, like different answers. Then it would be 2 to the n, 3 to the n, and you wouldn't have this piece. So if you had gotten 2 and 3, you would get 2 to the n, 3 to the n. If you get 4 and 5 as answers, it's 4 to the n, 5 to the n. But whenever it's repeated, you write it twice and you have to put an n there. So again, if you've seen differential equations, if you've solved these types of differential equations that use this, this will seem familiar. So we're here. 1 to the n is 1, so for convenience, I'm just going to write this as C1 plus, I'm going to put the n in front of the C2. Okay, so this is the answer to this. Now we have to impose our initial conditions to actually find the C's, and then we're done. So to do that, let's use this one first. So a sub 1 equals 1.5. So I'm going to go ahead and put the 1.5 here. And then our n is 1, right? Our n is 1. So it'll be C1 plus C2. Beautiful stuff. Really clean, right? C1 plus C2. A sub 2 equals 3, so I'll put the 3 here. And our n is 2 in this case, so it'll be C1 plus 2C2. So C1 plus 2C2. Very, very pretty stuff, right? So again, when n is 1, we get C1 plus C2 because n is 1, and we set it equal to 1.5. When n is 2, we get C1 plus 2C2, and we set it equal to 3. Now we can simply subtract. I'm going to do it. I'm going to subtract. So 1.5 minus 3 is negative 1.5. C1 minus C1 is 0. C2 minus 2C2 is negative C2. So we end up with C2 equals 1.5. So that is our C2. Now that you have C2, you can plug this in back in here to find C1. Again, all we did was subtract, right? 1.5 minus 3 is negative 1.5. C1 minus C1 is 0. And then C2 minus 2C2 is negative C2. Now what you do is you take this and you plug it back in here. So we end up with 1.5 equals C1 plus, oh, look at this. They cancel, right? You subtract the 1.5 from both sides, and something beautiful happens. We get C1 equals 0. So we have C1 equals 0, C2 equals 1.5. We simply take these answers and we plug them back into this equation here, and we're done. Actually, let's plug them back in here, right? Because the 1 to the n, it's redundant, right? 1 to the n is 1. So the final answer would be a sub n equals, let's see, our c sub 1 is 0, c sub 2 is 1.5, and just n, right? Just n. So 1.5n. I believe that would be at 0 plus 1.5n. Yep, that's it. So this would be the solution to this recurrence relation together with these initial conditions. So a really nice problem. This arises mainly if you're taking like a discrete mathematics class, that's where you would see something like this. So at least in the US, if you're like a computer science major, you may be seeing stuff like this in your classes. I first saw this in discrete math many years ago. So kind of a fun problem. And again, the technique is really cool because if you study differential equations, if you haven't studied it yet, you'll notice that when you solve higher order linear differential equations, the technique is pretty much identical. It's just the matching is a little bit different here, right? It's a little bit trickier to match. So if you have an a sub n, it's x squared. If you have a sub n minus 1, it's x, and that's a constant. I just say memorize it because it always works. I hope this video has helped someone out there in the world. Until next time, take care.